with a story because I don't want to hear the story, right? A part two we say, right? And we're not picking a side. But in all honesty though, guys, I want you guys to really and truly understand that as bad as thing may be, the live nice and it's festive, but I do have good intentions for the show. You know, at the end of the day, I don't want you guys to be going back and forth with each other. I'm going to talk about this last night and I'm coming like, could not learn. I'm going to come like, so fool head tougher than anything. You know, so I'm not fun to stay back. And no, for I don't stay about this year and I'm gonna keep my class party because I'm gonna plan a big class party. And I'm gonna invite the ice cream truck. Cause some man may never care about a little finger come gonna eat ice cream at the ice cream truck. When I hear banana dun dun manana. Cause I told your mother say you're not getting none. Oh no man never used to care and got an ice cream truck. I don't never used to get a good Captain's Bakery ice cream cake. And somebody I keep a class party for the way. So because I don't so behave bad, but now but I keep my class party cancel. Because I don't learn how to behave on yourself. May I keep my life and I want uno for really and truly live in a unity. And every day as the life lock off, a next war start. The life is 6666. I don't like them number there. Two more six up on my life at the mark of the beast that. I saw me know the life in a safe tonight. But at least I keep tonight. Oh, go. But ladies, I'm telling you guys, please. This best friend situation, on a need for real and truly check on a friend, don't wreck on a friend. Love on a friend, support on a friend. And to how the video them look, it look like so them leave Kefa by road for she and up you play hide and seek. But them say, them give them story last night. And I really appreciate Nashan for stopping by and Shamil and giving their views. I'm not jumping to conclusion. I'm not like that. Because in all honesty, and on a brag thing, I don't know, I'm about lipping on my head back. Because someone knows a real world cheer that start. And that is why I want to get to the bottom of the story and rectify it and keep it moving. Okay, people? I'm not being biased. I was really appalled by the fact that she was left outside by herself as a female. And I made that clear. I am not being biased. I'm using the platform to promote unity amongst females and a lot of women up on the show and man, but the man them silent. The most the man them are going to do when they start talking, them not going to talk. But me don't want to take the life thing out of proportion. That is why I'm so stop keep live. Believe it or not, I'm going to shut down school because I found a man to pay on a school fee. All right, so we're going to go straight into it and I really want to hear from the beautiful K-Fab. I wanted to do video chat with her because she's a live girl, but K-Fab decided she wanted to talk to you guys via the phone. So I'm going to have to dial K-Fab. I don't want to hear K-Fab. If you don't say K-Fab, say K-Fab. If you love a friend, call him a friend name. A friendship of memories. When you are weak, I will be strong. Helping you to carry on. See, it's hurting you. Ah, yes, nice. Store come to bumps. Wanna can't hear the phone ring, Keisha? Hello. Hey, Kadeem, what's up, baby girl?
I'm here, Marky. Hi.
Hold on, let me turn it up. Wanna can't hear? Kadeem.
Yeah, you hearing me?
It don't sound so clear. I'm gonna put it on speakerphone then. Yes, baby, what's up?
You hearing me now?
Yes, we can hear you now. So how are you doing, first of all?
First of all, last night, I took one of the pain medication that I got from the doctor. I was exhausted, and it kept me in a deep sleep. That's why I didn't call in last night, to make it clear about what happened.
Me think I bantam, you the bantam, because I said, where is K-Fab? I mean, I tried video call, because like, I know your girl will love the face thing and the face time, but me couldn't hear you. So me, I wonder, where were you?
I fell asleep because I took the medication that they gave me, so I was blocked out. And I get up after the live, after 11, and I saw the drama.
You saw the drama?
About them calling in and the lies that were told. And I'm just here to make it clear that there is, towards the situation, there's a lot of things that I can't touch on because it's an open case. I filed the report, and it's been preceded by the New York City Department, and it's a serious thing that happened to me. It's no joke, and I just want to make it clear that I was abused by Shamil and her boyfriend, and it was videoed. The lies saved me in a lot of ways, because if it wasn't the lies, a lot of people wouldn't even believe that Shamil did that, because she keeps saying that she's not that type of person. She's not that type of person, and it was shown on video what type of friend and what type of person you are.
Okay.
I can rephrase from saying friend, because I watched back the live just to get a feel of what was going on, and I see she said that we weren't friends from Jamaica. I would backtrack a little bit. I won't go too much into details, but I want to make it clear.
Okay, so let me give me a second to steer this K-Fab. You and Shamil was friend from Jamaica.
Yeah, we have all picked and everything together.
All right, give me a quick history of you and Shamil's friendship.
Okay, we were we go out and stuff like that. Shamil has my number. I have Shamil's number. Whenever Shamil has a boyfriend, even with her ex, she always calls me with the issue. Maybe I'm that kind of friend then, the problem friend that you let your secrets to, and you tell your issues, because I'm always helping her in that department. Maybe that's the type of friend I was to her, but I thought that we had a genuine friendship. Anyways, from Jamaica days, when Nina and I have our issues, she always call me and I always give her advice. Sometimes we go to lunch and stuff like that, which I don't post. Instagram was not prominent that time.
Right, Jamaica. Instagram wasn't popular.
And all of that, when we were in Jamaica. Anyways, she came up here, she got herself in some trouble, and she reached out to me again. I helped her out, and she came up here. I don't know if you remember the incident when she and this girl did the whole teasing saga, and she didn't come out about it, but I know the whole situation. And you know, from once you have a criminal record and you're coming in on a visa, it would have been an issue. I got her out of that situation. So even when Shamil posted and she was here, she has been here for over 2 months. Nobody knew that because I got her through immigration. I got her here.
So you're saying basically after Shamil had the issue with the shoplifting case, allegedly, you helped her out.
Yeah, it's not even allegedly. It went into court and everything. She went to court. She went to court about it and everything. I helped her out of that situation. So when Shamil is talking about we weren't friends, I don't know how would you contact somebody that you are not friends with to help you out of a deep situation, knowing that the whole Instagram, the whole Facebook, everywhere are telling about the situation. I wasn't your friend then.
Okay, good. So Yan Shamil had a history. Now,
exactly.
Good. Now, on the night of the event, you guys were in the party together and everything. I saw the videos. You guys looked beautiful as usual. You know, regular girl thing. Walk me through what happened leaving the car. Of course, you both looked intoxicated. Now, Sean made it clear he doesn't drink.
He doesn't drink. That's why I thought that he shouldn't have done what he did to me. Knowing that even if you thought that me and Shamil was drinking, because I wasn't drinking a lot. And if her friend can be, or his friend can be fair, they knew that I wasn't drinking a lot.
So but you weren't as drunk as we...
I wasn't drunk. I was drinking, but I wasn't drunk. Anyway, he doesn't drink. He drinks water, according to him. So even if he thought that whatever we had escalated, he should have been the sober one to not abuse me and put his hand on me and even control his girlfriend.
All right, let me get this. Wait, give me a second, Kadeem. Let me get this straight, because I'm basing this conversation for the whole week about friendship. So after she come out, you guys used to party a lot, because I go to a lot of parties and I see you guys standing together. Were you guys like really legit friends, or just more so like party buddies or homies? Were you guys used to hang out even on the low?
In Jamaica, let me tell you, I had my business, and sometimes, I wouldn't say that we hang out a lot, but when she was going through stuff, I was there for her.
No, I'm talking here in the U.S., like within the past year at least.
No, Shamil used to live at my house, Shamil lived at my house for 8 months.
How long ago was this?
When she moved out. I don't even know the dates, you know, but you see, when the whole situation broke out with him and his girlfriend, she had moved out. Actually, I had put her out. We had an issue at that time. Not exactly. Nashawn went to the extent of leaving Crystal was because I put her out and she didn't have anywhere to stay. So he had to take the responsibility. And that's how, I don't know if that they grew closer or whatever happened, but it pushed him to do a lot in that aspect.
So you basically, all right, so it's safe for me to say you guys were really good friends. Good. All right,
we were good friends. And I even a lot of my friends that are not her friends knew that I had Shamil as a friend. Because stuff that I do for Shamil, I don't do for any other of my friends. I kept Shamil's secret with Nashawn for a year. For a year. And nobody knew, not even my close friend, them never knew. Yeah, you were saying something? Sorry.
So basically a good friendship. Oh, so sad.
But according to her, we weren't as close. So I don't know. I'm just stating the fact.
All right. So walk me through the party scene. Now you're leaving the club and you're jumping in the car. The argument starts. Pandora Highway. You leave. Go.
All right. Listen. What happened? We were in the party, partying and everything. She, me and Shami talk a lot every day. Every day, which every friend do. If you not, she said me and I not friend, but if we not a real friend, we not gonna talk every day. All right. There's a lot of instances where I try to stay away from other people because I see that they are out to get me. You understand?
Right.
At the end of the day, we went to this party and Shamil went over to everybody that she knows and me and her talk about these people out to get me and Shamil go over to the people them. It's not the people them approaching her in any way, no. She going over to all these people. But in myself, I said, Kadeen, you know what? People do what they want to do. Let it slide. We were coming out of the party. She was holding my hand from behind. Even before we were coming out of the party, all the argument started was because of somebody that we knew from Jamaica.
A mutual friend?
My mutual friend, but she and the girl was more of a closer friend. She and the girl used to be together. You understand?
Right.
They were friends and they were together. Anyways, we're there and the girl, she claimed because she was the one who said it to me. She had looked at me, you know. She knows the way of things, you know. This and that. She had chatted the girl. When we come out to the party, the girl shook off her hair. Hey, she hug up the girl. You understand? She hug up the girl. So me, I look at me like, you go over there to everybody where abandon me. You come up to the girl where you just a chat. We walk out and the girl and follow her. From Jamaica days, the girl said to me, from Jamaica days, I don't know like, I don't know what to talk to me. She talk to me, and honestly, Marky, I'm a realist, and that's why a lot of people think about me as a bad person, I don't know. But they might think that I'm very mean. Yep. But you see, if I chat you in a chat, me I'm gonna chat you even in front of your face. And if I see you, I'm not gonna talk to you, I'm not gonna fake with you. I'm gonna say, you know, me not wanna be with you, and then I'm gonna fake. And that's what Shamil did, and that is all the argument escalated in the car. Anyway, back to walking out the club now. The person might be on the live and can attest to this. She and her friend was there. We walked through and they kept, four of us kept walking out. We walked out the club together. Them a chat and them a chat. Shamil dep on our foot and our tar. She said, so why me not talk to the girl? Me not answer in front of the girl. But when we walked away, I said, Shamil, I cannot be friends with somebody that me definitely knows that I don't like. And you don't like the girl neither. So me not know why you end up looking at the girl all of a sudden. We walk and we walk to the car and anything. We did a chat. We did in the car and talk or whatever. She had talked her side of the story saying, I know the girl from Jamaica. She and the girl are friends. I'm meet to talk to the girl because the girl has nothing against me. But said, Shamil, I like the girl. I chat the girl every day. And as a matter of fact, the girl has been here more than 3 years. And you know, to done the girl to all the girls who are walking, fuck man and fuck drug man, to sing and fuck everything. And no, because this is the girl, they're with a man now. And we are looking pieces, you want to be friends with her. I'm not going to be friends with her. So she turned around and said, so all me friends with one of my friends when look up in everybody. But then no matter, some people have friends in a market. And you know all your friend traits, right?
Right.
And you can accept them for that trait. But I can attest, and that was why she was mad. I attest to her in front of her boyfriend that even though the person knows, me can know that the girl is fucky fucky, and the girl not see a certain way. And I can accept her as my friend. Oh, me I take up for the person. Me I take up for the person. But see, I'm not taking up for the person, but I'm being real. Shami, you only want to be friend with this person right now, in which you there 2 years, the girl there a year before me and you, but you only want to be friends with her now because this is just Oh. You know, to me, I'm lying, me, and this, and me, and that. I pull out my phone because I'm always aggressive. I said, see, there are 2 days ago, Shami show me the girl. I said, the girl, big life, up and down, look good, and why she just took up herself, so. Eh? You have done the girl 2 days ago, and now you see the girl, you want to be friends with her because you see the girl, I move up and move up in her life. That is not right, these are pink friends. I'm going to start talking some things in the car, yes? In which me not business, I'm not take it back because I'm real. You understand that? I'm going to talk my truth.
Right.
Anyway, we were driving and driving. Drive on the highway because we never get food, as he said. The argument I talk and we are talking and I talk. And because I'm talking my real and I guess a lot of things that I was saying hurting her. And a lot of things that I stated in the car that Sean didn't know about. She thinks that me should not say that. So all she said, me talk to her in her man car like that. Me said, Shamil, when you come pick me up from my yard, I'm supposed to drop me off anywhere me want to go because me supposed to talk my man. Anyway, it's a driver and a drive and a go on. Now Sean him, what is up, Maggie? Now Sean him, I drive and then Shamil, I say, I'm not talk to Nashan like that because Nashan do a lot of things for me. So I said, stick a couple buttons right there, so. What Nashan do for me? Every time Nashan I sell a Chanel bag, 5 grand, 6 grand, the most him take off a 2 bills to me. Every time I know that Nashan do anything for me, I pay for it. If it's the fact that if we go out and party and I buy the liquor and I drink out, I don't know if that's your talk about. You hear him say it on the live, say so me do my 9 to 5. I work, Marky. I work for every single thing I have in life. I owe me make my way to America. So me never respect the fact when she come talk about me. I talk to Nashan like that and Nashan do things to me. Like Nashan is my man and Nashan take care of me. Me not take them talking. Them I drive from the highway and because me I talk my truth and me I talk owe me one talk. Nashan want put me out on the highway, man.
Wait, at one point she said you said something very bad about her boyfriend.
Alright, the part when she was saying that Nashan did a lot of things for me. That was the part when I was saying, what you do for me, Nashan? What you do for me? I don't know if that was in the line. But so what you do for me, Nashan? What you do for me? And him not answer. So I look funny, she and I asked her, so what you talk about still what Nashan do for me? Because every time I know someone buy something from him, me give him money. So I don't know what Nashan do for me.
And let me get this straight, Kadeem. Did you go live purposely or it was an accident?
That's what I'm about to get at.
Okay.
Alright, we drive from the party, we were on the highway. Because of what the whole thing that was happening, he was offended that I was stating to him that he never do nothing for me, which Nashan never do nothing for me, for true. As me said, if we go to one party and he know the people, then he might get the ticket and when we go in, he might buy the liquor. Who never take that? Come on. But you're not feed me, you're not close me, you're not do nothing for me. Me not drive, you come pick me up all the time. Even before the party started, this party, I told them to leave me. I'm not sure, I said, you're mad man, me I come see you. Tell me what time you have already, and then tell them I come to me after 6. Anyway, past that, so we're up on the highway now. We're up on the highway now, and he must say, I'm going to let me out on the highway, but look here, them are zoop spot, zoop. Them could have come out at the same time to come to me. Right, but let me out. Come and sit down. You know the car and a train.
Right.
Him drive. Go down the two of them. I get. You have to be look class. Come out. You have to come out. That's all this is bad. Oh, you don't feel tense. That's all stuff.
So again, Kadeem, you volunteer to come out of the car first, or them say them want you out?
No, Marky.
I'm asking you because me I go for what them tell me last night. Cause the people me have to rectify
that's
both
why
ways.
I called in tonight and I'm trying to make it happen to my father. You understand? A girl made me knock out because they had to speak so I could come on. You understand? A girl make it happen that way then. Oh, me for tell him to let me out on highway, Marky. Tell truth now. Oh, me for tell him to let me out on highway. Somebody ever really do that in their mind for somebody let them out on the highway?
I don't know.
I could have tell that to let me out on the highway. Mother can bring me back to me yard where you pick me up and they say you pick me up. But now, come out.
And Nashan volunteer for come for you, right?
Of course. I have the text in my phone. But she has to say, Kadeem, make sure you get ready in the car. We are come for you whatever time.
Okay.
She loves the fucking text. She loves the text.
Okay.
Anyway, when they find the highway, he might say, I'm going to go around the next time to take me out. Because he really
Okay, so it got live on accident, and then you run with it.
Yes.
Perfect.
Yes, that part.
All good.
Right. When we did put the mark here, the person and some of them on the road and two people will look like one were ready to beat me and kill me. You can't expect no good from that if them a drive off of one road. You think that somebody will look to do something.
Yeah, and you're a female, so I'm sure you were scared. So walk me through the process when he came out of the car to grab you.
No, before that, I don't know if you saw the live when the phone incident. Shamila said she didn't hit me. If you look in the video, you saw when me and Shamila argued. I mean, I said, take your hand out of my face. Take your hand out of my face. And she gets up and kneel down in the front of the seat and come in on my face. And then she turned around and lick me. So get the fuck out. Or something like that.
So she lick you, she never bats the phone out of your hand.
And lick me in hand?
I think I lick, she lick the phone in your hand or she lick you?
No, she lick me in my chest and then me lick her back and so the phone rumble out. Because I defend myself. And
oh.
The phone come from around the front seat now. Come drag me out, don't fight me and beat me up.
Okay, so I saw when Nashan came out of the car, came out, him grab some stuff and then him grab you. Him grab you by your hand or... Walk me through
by
that process.
By my hand.
And then you come
on the side and grab me by my hand and draw me out and beat, top me in my belly, top me in my chest.
Wait. So he said you were holding on to his blazer and he'm going to try to get you off of the blazer and then him drive off. You're saying that the...
No, Mark, here, listen. If me sit down in the car, hold me on the grab hand for Nashan blazer. Him have to draw me out and beat me up for me to defend myself.
I know, I saw me fight too.
I don't have no ear from the wall and in here. I don't have no ear.
So when
you're a woman fight.
So when you're out of the car, you're saying he physically assaulted you then?
Yes.
And punching your belly.
Me up and push me down. And then, remember the phone is gone, you know. And me didn't notice me after the phone, they found life. And me, I try to search my things, because remember them threw up everything over in the trash.
So when, and I heard Shamali's voice while you were outside and the tussling. So while Letta Gwan, she was in the car still or she came out?
She came out. She was standing by the passenger door. No, by the what do you call the passenger where she did sit on?
Oh, the passenger side. And she never, yes. She never licked you again then?
No, she never licked me again then, Tana, because he was already beating me up. I'm already the man angle me, that's why my nails tear off Marky because I was defending myself. Nashan say him don't lick me Marky. I don't even want to tear up because I feel so emotional about it. That's why they had to give me the pills that they gave me to knock me out. You understand? I'm gonna sleep one day yesterday. And it's only because Shamil said that I was pressing charges. Let them come from the life. Shamil don't come stop me and say sorry. You understand, Marky? I'm your Shamila. Friend, I'm a whole Shamil secret, them. Shamil knows that Nashan is an abuser. Shamil have recorded the mental asylum of what she run out of the camp and Nashan have eaten. I'm a whole them secret, there. And Shamil come for life and tell Nashan no, I never do it. And she knew. The last time over them apartment, the people, them can't put notice under them door, I said. If the police have to come to the apartment one more time, they have to be evicted. Shamil, you're wicked!
So, Kadeem, I'm so sorry. I know you're emotional. After they drove off, how did you get help?
All right, Marky. Boy, may I tell you. My search for the phone, I'm not saying nothing, I'm quiet, because I'm saying no to the phone, they find life now, right?
Yeah.
I search for the phone. If you listen, you hear the trash. I saw me up here, like I look at Scrabby Dog. I saw me up here, I search through the trash room. I saw me call the phone now, light up. I find the phone, I'm going to cover the screen right here. So I'm show
Chrissy,
face.
Chrissy says it sounds familiar. Hi, Chrissy. Oh, God, it's not safe. But you can continue.
Anyway, I search for the phone. I'm going to take up the phone, my hide the screen, I'm going to end this something. Everybody are calling, but me, I try to get help because I'm in the wilderness. I don't know where they're not answer nobody because obviously people see from the line. I call email and somebody a fight because they didn't even know about the live at that time. So them I said, what? Which part? And me I said, no, it's me. Nashawn and Shamil just beat me up and came up on a lonely road and drive off left me. And the person I said, what? Which part? Tell me where you're there. May I come now because we are left the place or whatever. Me said, me don't know where me there is a lonely road and the place dark. And then said, which part you're there? Me said, them drive off the highway and came up on a lonely road and push out, dash on me things them. Beat me up and show me on the road and drive garless me. So the person said, what you ever do? If you can't come to you, I don't know your location. I'm clicking on my head and say, never share my location to you. I share the location. The person come back and say, it's not even really. I tell me where you're there, but I just have a driver and follow it. All right, them hang up. I call 911. The same thing the dispatcher woman has said, which farm are there? I said, ma'am, I don't know where I'm at. But it's very emotional, crying and all these things. I said, I don't know where I'm there. But she said, don't say another word. I can, whatever them do for the GPS, to know which farm they there. And them said, I'm going to send the police. Anyway, the person reached before the fire department and whatever, because when they got there, my driver was going at 2 seconds and then them called me. I told them that somebody come and get me. So they said, due to the situation, I must make my way to the nearest police station and whatever. And that was what I did.
Okay. How long were you there by yourself for?
Oh. Me not really, about 5 minutes, 3 minutes, me not really know. Me never had a check the time. Everything went by so fast. Marking my blackout, me not know what to do. But all me I think about that whoever come from around here stuff, or whoever happened to me. Because the place so dark, me not see nothing. It's just dark.
And not care never did a pass?
All me I think about.
Not care never did a pass?
No, because it's off the highway. It's like, I don't know what to say. It's like one hill the day. You can't see the car them up on the highway, you know, but you can't even go over there because a fence. There's a mesh fence that backs the highway off from where I was.
I'm sorry you had to go through this. I must say that. And you, in fact, you did say he physically armed you on spot. And did they reach out to you and try to, you know, make ends, like, you know, make up?
No.
She did spoke vocally that she's sorry about the situation.
I saw that she called me today. And it's the only thing I can surmise is that because she saw that I'm going forward with this. And I'm really going forward with it, Shamil. And I was abused by you and your boyfriend. And I have the bruises to prove. Him said never leave me. So only have so much bruises, Nashawn. Why my nails pop off? All I do is say you drag me out of the car. So all me have bruises for me. I have bruises all over my arm and I post everything because, as we said, it's an ongoing matter which is going to go to court with something ever happen. You understand? So I can't even see it or post so much stuff.
So you...
It's very traumatic in a way that I went through so much at the hospital. I have to get days off. If you think it was so simple... You think a doctor that evaluated me could have thought that I needed that?
Right.
Nobody are not dumb. Nobody are not idiot. You physically abused me and your woman and what Shamil do to me. And I come talk about me and I never a friend. Been a friend for 2 years just like Nashawn. Shamil, I'm sorry for you. I don't know who you ever call I'm bald to again, you know. I don't know who you ever called to unbox. So again, you know, get a birthday celebration on my yard today when Nashawn put up that long blood clot essay. And you kiss your teeth. And Mr. Shamil, come in because the people them are going to see something wrong. Shamil, I have and I was there for you.
So you and Shamil,
you understand? I have and I was there for you.
And so where do you see yourself going now with this? Like you're going to continue with the case and it's over for you and Shamil as friends. There's no reconciliation?
No reconciliation. Okay, I'm moving forward with the case.
I do respect your privacy. I want you to take some time, Kadeem, and I'm being sincere. Get some time for yourself, you know, take some time off and really,
yeah.
You know, I hope you're...
I get the time off from work because they, at the hospital they gave me the... 4 days, and I sent it to my workplace, and it was up to, and I needed time. So.
All right, get some rest, and I really appreciate you for calling in and give your view. I am so sorry that you had to go through this, and it was so public.
And I can't because they're going to therapy right now, every Friday and Saturday about this, and I don't want to go into details too much. You just said to me, say, it's about look bad if you're lesbian, but me think that you're left. Stop your face for Instagram. Because you're going through a deep depression and you're going through therapy right now about it, I'm going to think that you need for those leave that man. You see what I'm doing to me, you see what I'm doing to you all the time. He beat you up, he bust up your mouth, he do so much things. So me leave him. Because if him abuse me and I say not do it, I see him to him deny every time when he do it to you. So me leave the situation. We are not going to ever be friends anymore, but that's just all I'm saying to you. As somebody that was your friend. All right, Marky, good night, and good night to everybody.
Thank you for calling in, K-Fab, and have a wonderful night.
All right, bye-bye.
Be safe.